went to another stage further who, because I genuinely didn't know if you were going to play it again. Picked up Karen Bowman getting. I didn't know that. I totally forgot the storyline. In fact, I won't say anything now because obviously, I don't know if you remember it. Do you?
No.
Do you know what happened?
No.
Okay, I should have done because it was a surprise to me. I did learn something from it though. I got
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Akatar and these rebels. They're kind of.
Okay.
Forgiven you are.
Hang on, I'm just trying to find my gun. Where's the gun? Oh, there it is. Of course, the most important part is the paint job for mine. Oh, that'll do. Pistol.
Why can't I join you? That's weird.
Ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and a firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find Amaru.
Ooh-ah.
Good old Amaru.
I wonder if it's still a string of the storyline that we haven't encountered before. Because, you know, there's certain intel files you don't get to pick up or do. And why can't I even see you online? That's weird.
Oh, I can't see you online, but I can. I just sent you an invite.
So yeah. So if it's a different storyline, I was shocked at what and who. Shall I tell you? It's probably fucking easier.
Go on.
So, someone said they spotted Alfano. And you go to this encampment to go and see what he is.
Mm-hmm.
There's nobody there. You search your body, turn it over, and it's Amaru.
Oh, he's really? Dead. Oh.
Yeah. So, you phone up Karen, and she said she's in trouble. And it turns out Pat Katari's gone fucking dark.
Oh, really? Oh, wow.
Yeah. So.
I thought he was dark anyway, but, you know.
Well, I said I did. I thought the next phase of this mission, this thing would have been he sees power and now you've got to fucking go through his bunch.
Oh.
But of course, as soon as you. So you speak to Karen Bowman, set her free, and you've got a timer, like you said, to get to his mausoleum.
Mm-hmm.
Which is about 8 minutes, I think. As soon as you get outside, all of them, all of Pat Katari's fucking people turn on you and start to shoot at you.
Oh my god.
Get into this car. I'm doing this car, trying to this race as quick as I can to the big mausoleum. So I've got to get through all of Pat Katari's men, all the Unidad, all of the Santa Blanca to get to them. I didn't do it, by the way. I didn't make it. I failed with about 30 seconds to go.
Oh.
And then just for shits and giggles, while I was up there, I saw there's 5 skill points to be grabbed. So I
must
activate Karen.
Have skill points.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't activate Karen, which meant all of the people who were liberating was still on my side. I went up there and snuck past the fucking Santa Blanca guys. Killed the top end of them, got the 5 skill points and just got the fuck out of there. But what I learned from that is, I fucking got on the map, I probably can't find it now. I took a screenshot just in case. Yeah, so Sueño's museum is here. I've just marked it on the
it's
map.
It's in Pekara, isn't it?
Pekara, yeah.
I can see your marker, yeah.
Okay, so everywhere you go along that journey,
mm-hmm.
which is obviously you select the highlighted drive. There's roadblocks, there's tanks, trucks, choppers, a lot. But if you take the train route,
which is what?
Okay, you got it.
From memory, it was either with you or with Marcus, and we eventually found a route where you could just follow the train track.
Yeah, we did. It was me and you. I remember it.
Ah, okay.
So, if you can take the train track, you have to dodge the train, obviously, if you pass it by, but it's a cleaner entry up to the mausoleum. The mausoleum, you're still going to fight your way up.
Yeah.
With that part, at least, you've got yourself a fighting chance without all the roadblocks.
So, in the strategy guide, which is like quite a thick tome, like, but the El Sueño thing is quite, it's like a couple of pages, and you'd think, okay. But what they say basically, right, is you just, because I think you've got a 15 minutes from where you start to get to the mausoleum.
Oh, okay.
Because it doesn't start immediately, I don't think, the timer. It's after a certain point. And it just basically says you just get yourself an armored car and barrel through everything that comes across your path. And then when you get to the mausoleum, you just drive up, just keep driving up and just through the barricades and all this kind of shit. And just try, you know, just try and hammer it through. Or it says, get a chopper. You can do it in 2 minutes, and it's just like, hang on a minute. But
it's
then
that easy, like, yeah.
Yeah, but then it says, you know, but do be careful of all the missiles that come your way. It's just think, no shit.
I took a car which was next to me, quite a caravan, a wild straight away. Jumped in a car, drove around. I went through one actually, which was a disaster. I over rocks and a few cliffs and God knows what else. So the car, whilst it was being shot, was fucking smoking. And I then got, and of course, it was a gunner car, so some of the guys were shooting. But I got out and went into another car. And then you're right, I did try and barrel up the stairs, but.
It's that short, I'll read it to you. So it's like a header, Monte Octo Picaro. Other tactical advice. This is solo or co-op. Now you can take the main road. It's quicker to try a direct path from the RP to Bowman's last known location. However, if you're biking down these scree slopes, expect to fall off a couple of times. It's worth arriving here in an off-road military vehicle or helicopter. And the journey to Picara is much easier. You can also start the journey to Picara as soon as the body is identified while you're talking to Bowman and before the timer starts to save some time. Then it goes on to...
Set up again.
You can also start the journey to Picara as soon as the body is identified while you're talking to Bowman and before the timer starts to save you some time. Then there's a little bit about... He says you have 15 minutes... to reach the mausoleum, and it's just saying travel by road, and if anybody tries to stop you, just go straight through. But the co-op to the mausoleum, tactical advice co-op. Co-op planning allows you to have the variety of vehicles at your disposal as the mission commences. While heading to from the village on bikes, as hilarious a plan as it is dangerous, taking two or more helicopters, a convoy of armoured vehicles and storming the place or accessing the mausoleum quickly displays a degree of competency you can be proud of. But it just says, it's just not really... The rest of the thing's pretty good. But the actual mission that matters, it's not really that helpful. Anyway, I'm going to travel to Alpha, because it's closer.
Okay.
Because I never remember to do this. Yeah, because that last mission from memory is just mental. Absolutely mental. Why on earth you'd want to take a helicopter? Beyond me. Try and land it. While everybody's trying to shoot it.
Be crazy.
Hang on, I'll drive.
They are a sign of who you have become. Indeed.
I mean, of course, the other another alternative, but I don't know if it'll work or not because you can't do it when you're hunting. So there's part of the journey there where I wasn't hunting because I'd finally lost my tail, whoever's chasing me or whatever. But I'm thinking if we had someone already at the railway, and we travelled, so we can't travel to any of the safe houses because it's going to be full of fucking guys, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
But if we get someone already up there and travel to the railway nearby, you're going to circumnavigate all the fucking shit.
So what are you saying on this mode that we're on? Everybody turns against us.
Yeah.
Shit.
You even get a chance to speak to Pat Catara, and he says, because he asks him why, and he says, because I want Bolivia to be free. You know, I don't need to be under any influence from the Americans or the Yankees.
Right. After all that help, how many deaths?
Really shocked, yeah, exactly.
I don't want to spook the target. Switch to suppressors.
I don't remember that path taking place when we did it.
No, not at all. Mind you, it's been some years since we played the thing.
Deploying the drone. Second target, right there.
Hit the guy up top.
Count is now 5. Target eliminated.
Ding.
Rats, mate.
Well, I'm just locked in. Thanks, Greg.
On the target. Let's move.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. Low entiendes?
Cheer the fuck up, cabrón. What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck.
I think he's at a toy farm.
I reckon.
We need to get this done in a hurry. Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead. Maybe, maybe not. Amaru's a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move.
Fuck, mate, that was terrible.
The first shot missed because he moved.
So the rebels can pick up these supplies
later. How dare they move?
He lollipopped over your bullets.
He did.
That's one less bad guy.
Let's get moving. The cartel ain't gonna wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
Yeah.
nation that made your beautiful country its home a mere 6 years ago. Many of you are now employed by our organization, and your communities have benefited from our economic investment and from our charitable contributions. Yet, despite all of our benevolence, we are slandered by your politicians, by foreign governments, and by the mainstream media. They call us criminals and murderers. They even call us terrorists. Ustedes saben la verdad. But look at your own towns, your own villages. The facts are that, aside from the troubles caused by rebels, since Santa Blanca has arrived in Bolivia, crime is down. Violent crime, theft, rape, they are all very nearly a thing of the past. Before Santa Blanca, the thieves and murderers and rapists would only need to pay your corrupt police a small fee, and they would be set free. But in Santa Blanca's territories, there is no haven for criminals such as these. There is no sanctuary. We punish these criminals when the police will not.
Oops.
If you need justice, when the judges and politicians let you down, when you have no one else to turn to, turn to us. We will be there.
Just have an arrest.
Esta es nuestra misión. I find that's the best place to catch a suntan. Shit, I found myself trapped in a rock as well.
What?
So it's all over. Fucking wave after wave of cars coming, nearly dead.
Yeah.
Slowly running out of bullets. Just, and the world around me was twitching because I wasn't getting a proper purchase on the ground around me.
Oh wow.
But now it's all over.
I got another Tango. Tango 5.
Right, you want to take a little chopper ride, sir?
Are you Amaru?
Where are you taking me?
Come on, we're getting you out of here.
Come this way.
There's cartel commendation here. This metal has a coca plant on it. It's kind of cool. I got eyes on a weapons case.
Ding.
I've been wanting one of these.
Thanks, Creed.
I heard. It would be lighter.
Now
this had a different meaning, this cutscene.
Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through. That's the rundown on Yuri and Polito. They're a key part of San Francisco's security operations. Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on their chain of command.
Guy in charge of security.
Here's some prestige points.
The Wall, personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño. El Muro's little brother is La Plaga. Nasty piece of shit. Very active on social media. Head Sicario for the cartel.
The hunt starts now. We want Sueño, we gotta work our way up
the
hierarchy.
The
first targets are Yuri and Polito.
Where we go? Need some intel. So it's gonna be there. We got Sleepy Joe Biden on the way.
You think Santa Blanca gives out a lot of these?
Nomad, I've got Pacatori on the line. Sounds like he needs our help.
Put him through.
Hola, compadre. I have a problem in Itaqua, and Bowman says you may be able to help. My people need help. There have been many losses to the cartel, and the horrors inflicted by Yuri Polito have broken their spirit. The fires of revolution have almost gone out.
Spare me the rhetoric, Katari. Just tell me what you need.
There is a cartel supply convoy passing through the province soon. Capturing it would give my people much needed supplies and restore their morale. Can you do this?
Consider it done.
Taking orders from Pat Katari now?
Katari needs this convoy. We're gonna give it to him. The more he depends on us.
Is there somebody dead in the middle of the road?
We can get out of him in return.
Yes.
Oh yeah. On a little pile of whatever. I know he's on a bit of fucking wood this time.
Yeah.
Esto es.
That's mental. It was a mound of tarmac before. Right, let's have to clear these bastards out.
Second target, right there. That tango's down. Deploying drone. We got a second target. Eyes on a third.
I'm looking at a small group of tangos.
Tango down.
Where? Using the wrong part of the gun for my sight.
Oh, really?
Let's go inside.
I'm spotting another tango.
Are you gonna?
I see a second target.
Ding.
That's one less bad guy.
You got a 20 on the garage where Polito parks his sports car. We snag that, we snag his GPS. Maybe something there will tell us where he and his girlfriend are.
Okay. Oh, we've got a convoy coming down the road. Let's go and get a car. This one will do.
And I'll drive. If they had marked your grave, I would piss on it.
Huh. What do you know?
Really better strong stuff.
They really are.
Shitballs.
Nailed it. Yeah, I think so. Yes. It's coming our way.
Yes. Oh, he's just turned right. Lying. Fucker, Andy.
We should have known that, really.
Bowman, you just arrived in Agua Verde.
Welcome to Narco Paradise. Agua Verde used to be a national park.
I'm shot and he's out already.
A place to wine and dine VIPs. Run by this narco junior called Carzita. He brings politicians, judges, and CEOs there for relaxation and cartel-sponsored debauchery.
What's the play?
We need to know who Sueño's making deals with. Carzita must
stop
have
reloading, dickhead.
You get him, you get the names.
Understood. We're on it. We got some intel
just
from Bowman.
We wasted about 40 rounds of ammo.
Well done. I'll have the rebels come pick this stuff up.
Double with the cutest Instagram account, Yuri Hipolito.
Hola, Perico.
¿Cómo va todo, man?
Welcome to the show.
Let's go into that convoy first.
Is on the verge of defeat. If we help him turn things around, we'll be able to counter his support in the future.
Oh, name is Ricky. Senor Ricky, what a guy. We knew him socially, you know.
A really fun guy.
Senor Ricky, what a guy.
We really like him.
But that's the business, you know. One day you're having jealous with a guy con un carnal.
The next day, you're giving him a turpentine and a... Pues bueno.
Así es la vida. or breaking his fingers with a ball peen hammer.
Our legs, you know, as a ship. People are always so afraid when you break their legs.
I broke my leg once. I jumped off a roof in the hood when I was a kid. Neta, it hurts.
Sure, fucking but, hell. You know, no sé. Mira, when we break our leg, people know. The way we shatter the tibia in three places, they know you they won't walk right ever again. Right.
Chale, was this part of your treatment with the gringo?
Que bueno, chica. Really not, huh?
That's one of the things I really liked about him. Chivato, but he's the tough one that forced you to be really creative.
Why is it taking through this goddamn town again?
Bueno, minutos. We'll hear more from these cuties in a few minutes. But for now, back to some tunes.
He's got death wishes, these people.
This province is part of the cartel's influence operation, their propaganda machine. We should familiarize ourselves with their MO.
The man at the top is El Cardenal, an excommunicated priest turned Santa Muerta proponent. He's also supposed to be the spiritual advisor to El Sueño. Other guy in the mix is Ramon.
Oh, done it again.
He used to be a legit journalist till he inexplicably started blogging for the cartel.
Oh, hang on. Seeing as we're here, we have no other reason to come here than to get the medal, do we?
Oh, yeah.
And to nick the chopper.
Nobody has come back into us again.
Gmods now, E. Don't have any progression. This is a fresh game. I died on our last, close to the end, but start again, that's where I am. Got pilot.
You have, yeah?
Yeah, okay, well, when you're ready.
Yeah, go,
that tank
go.
Goes down.
Eyes on a cartel supply chopper. Let's hijack it and divert its payload to the rebels instead.
Right, I'll take away the goodies.
Okay.
I'll pilot.
Is the truck coming past us?
It's probably the one that we need to get. You can fast travel to me, can't you, if I stay here?
Yeah.
Think I can wear this with my Class A uniform?
Shit up.
Chido, bro. I appreciate the comments. In actuality, I read a lot, DJ Perico. The French intellectual...
That was a fucking hoot. Nothing like swiping a helicopter to bring a day into focus.
And as he describes, there is an erotic element to the activity. Uh-huh.
You know?
And tangentially, I tried to exploit that element for the viewing audience.
So, in other words, you're a sick fuck.
La neta, sí, bro.
It stopped.
Alright, my fault.
What's that?
You shot me.
I shot you?
Yeah.
Here we go. Looks like an Unidad patrol. Got infantry with a radio truck in support.
Rebels could use a tech upgrade. You want to take them out?
Driver's out.
Tango down.
Objective secure. Let's clear out. We'll pass word to the rebels to come get the radio gear. Unidad's inserted troops into the province. We need to keep our
Not even down. A shiny. Hunted again.
Buckle up, people.
Right, so we got that's the Lambeau. This one is the, oh, there's Takatari's the convoy.
Takatari's rebel movement is on the verge of defeat. If we help him turn things around, we'll be able to counter his support in the future.
I didn't even notice that you'd gone in front of me. I thought I'd hit the driver.
I went to go. To get rid of this, do you want the intel?
Yeah.
Talking, fuckface.
Just suck it first.
Relax, Wei, I'll talk.
And don't pick shit, Cabron.
Chill the fuck out, Cabron! Let's just assume that you've got everything. No.
If it hasn't, I'll shout.
Okay. Oh, is that coming towards us? Oh, I forgot the accessory from a Toyo farm. Here it comes.
Plus a combo truck.
Qatar's people would like to get
yeah, I got the pilot.
What do you think, boss?
The car behind it whenever I struggle to hit.
It's gonna blow the truck up, isn't it? No, I'm getting in! Just tag the fucking thing! Jesus H.
Combo truck secure. Atari's people are on the way to come pick up the gear.
Target is down.
I thought it said tag. Oh my god,
Tag,
in
this is Nomad.
Truck.
The convoy is secure.
Gracias, amigo. My people will make good use of those supplies. My people are searching for La Yuri y El Polito, but in the meantime, there is something else you can do for us. I have prepared a speech for the people of Bolivia. It is a call to arms that we will broadcast from Itaqua.
Santa Blanca is going to send troops to shut that down as soon as they hear the transmission.
You see my problem? I need someone dependable to find a radio transmitter and protect it until the broadcast is complete.
Okay, broadcast. We'll get it done. There's a weapons case over here.
Oh, yeah. I'll reload. It's another helicopter mission, isn't it? Them all anyway.
Eyes on a small group of tangos.
Deploying drone.
I'm looking at a small group of tangos.
Third target. Count is now 5. Kill confirmed.
Wow, that was bad.
That dude goes down.
I was just trying to break his neck that you killed.
Yeah, that was him.
And I went through an animation. I don't know. I think I was picking his pockets or something. Like that. What's that other game where DayZ just checking your pulse when you're trying to get in the car?
Yeah.
It's like that.
This lists the location of a cartel commendation they're awarding to some guy who killed a few rebels.
This is where he dropped the chopper off, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Back Atari. You just can't trust him.
Yeah. Backstabbing.
It just, I know. It just feels so. Getting all this stuff now for the rebels. It just seems kind of pointless because you just want to. No. Fuck you.
Well, I am. When I failed the mission first time, and then I thought, well, if I don't pick up Karen, they're still on my side. And I thought, when it does kick off, I'll just have a lady, she can blow the mines down on the floor. And thought I'll have at least a head start getting out of the place. But I killed four of them in the car accidentally.
You'd think with all their money, the cartel would make a nicer medal.
It'll be an interesting one.
I asked Pacatari to send us a vehicle.
Right, let's go and get the. Oh no, that's the chopper mission, isn't it?
Pacatari's rebel movement is on the verge of defeat. If we help him turn things around, we'll be able to counter his support in the future.
Wow, this is dark.
You got your headlights on my screen.
I've got headlights on. It's just very dark.
Hang on.
You twat. Wow. Yeah, I can hardly see. Wow. Oh, it's a convoy just going past. It's been night vision. That's better.
Tango down. Target number 2, there. Eyes on a third. Target number 5.
The rebels need supplies badly, and that chopper's got them. Let's snag that bird and get it turned in the right direction.
Tango down.
Yes, we got the top pilot yet.
I don't know. Yeah, pilot's down.
Mierda, chingada
Target eliminated.
Oh shit, I've exchanged my gun by mistake.
Okay, I shall
What a cocklick. I wonder why's my scope gone? Oh, that's what I was doing. When you killed that guy and I was trying to I swapped my gun out. That's what happened.
Shows where we can find a deactivated rebel radio transmitter. We should go put it back on the air.
Pacatari's got some brass ones, I'll give him that. Give that fucker an inch and he'll take a mile.
If he can get us to Yuri and Polito, it's worth it. Let's get it done.
It's the AK-12. It's not too bad, actually. I'm not going to keep it, obviously. That's back at... Is that back at the farm where we've just...
Literally.
Okay. So you just come straight to me then.
Hell crushing rebels.
I'll head back to the car. Ding.
Rats, mate.
Thanks, mate. Actually, can I put physical? I can put physical on there, can't I? Bullet resistance. Yes, I can. Can I do two? I can. Can't do three. Actually, I need. Actually, the Toyo Farm's got the nearest thing, hasn't it?
Let's go.
Oh, I didn't even see her. I've just killed her. Run over a bloody civilian. So where is a Toyo farm? Thought it was on this stretch. Oh, there it is. Actually, it's easy enough to get to the back of those tents, isn't it, to get a refill?
Yeah.
It's really dark. Don't know why.
For me, the worst one is thunder and lightning and raining. That's the dark one for me.
This is the garage. Sound off if you spot Polito's car.
Roger that. I got another Tango.
Right, load it. Where's my gun?
Oh, the freaking truck going past us.
And relax.
Count is now five. Another target. Count is 10. target is down.
What happened there? Good throw.
The Sicarios are...
Hang on, I'll drive. There it is. Eyes on Polito's car.
Oh, I know. A few things to collect.
Got a cargo manifest here for a cartel supply plane. Shipment looks like it could go any time.
The rebels could really use that stuff. What do you think, boss? Want to steal a plane?
Looks like it came from a box of cereal at the Air Force or something. This car is swanky, and there's a bloody condom in the glove box. Make that two bloody condoms.
I guess that confirms it's Yuri and Polito's ride.
Even if the condoms come standard, it's a sweet fucking car.
I never could understand the narco bling. You get an expensive whip, put chrome rims on it, then you just drive it around the same dusty towns you were driving around before.
You totally want one of these cars, don't you?
Fancy car, fancy suit, still the GPS is not. So what's the point?
Air conditioning.
Hang on. I know where it is. It's just that I just found it strange that it's not GPSing for me. Why is he giving me a blue line instead of a yellow line? I can't change.
All they want is power, control. We have seen it before, all across the continent. But Santa Blanca has put your destiny as an individual back in your own hands. This is the reality of today, not some fantasy tomorrow you have to hope for. Es ahora, banda. No political party, no union is around to tell you how to run your life. We have given Bolivia the investment and the jobs that have helped you improve your lives. But Bacatari and his rebels...
No fans again?
All right. Now it's up to Bowman and the activity. He'll check the car's GPS for locations where Yuri and Polito may be hiding out.
Okay, so there's...
Pacatari's rebel movement is on the verge of defeat. If we help him turn things around, we'll be able to...
We go to Bravo?
Oh, I've got to get my fucking thing on. Shut up. Did the mission come up for you, for this car?
It did, but I couldn't get it to go yellow, because it was... The GPS wasn't on, but when I clicked on the arrow, it was blue, and I thought, is this going to complete for me? But it did.
It did, okay, as long as it didn't for me, but don't worry.
So this is the broadcast now, so it's got to Bravo.
Yep.
Right, we can walk it from here, can't we? Oh no, we can't.
Yeah. It's 500 away, either. Well, something is.
Pacatari's rebel movement is on the verge of defeat.
Just 2.3 kilometers, sorry.
We'll be able to counter his support in the future.
I don't know what that is.
But that's definitely the mission, we can walk to it. Can we? Sure we can.
Yeah, we can.
No, it's... Oh, what? What on earth is it doing? There we go.
On the verge of defeat. If we help him,
no, it's still showing me.
Counter his support in the future.
I keep clipping on it, clicking on it. Oh, I can fast travel there.
Yeah, well done.
I kept highlighting it, but it was showing me my original where we dropped the car off. That's why it was 2 kilometers away. That's ridiculous. No bugs in this game.
Target eliminated.
Oh, Proxmire. That's it, but yeah, that should do it. That's nice. So I forgot we haven't come by car this time, so.
Up.
I'm ready when you are.
Up in my other two mines. Right, I'll hit the button now.
Car coming my way. Gonna be a civilian killed. Another car my way. Another civilian killed. Going for the hat trick, you know. The car my way. Up behind me.
Got another tango.
Tango down.
How did that not blow him up? The Proxima was right where he was.
Got his message out. That should get his people stirred up.
Well done, compadres. My speech was heard all over Bolivia. It is only a matter of time before the people rise up and join our cause. Viva la revolucion!
Glad we could help. Now, what have you got on Yuri and Polito?
Nothing yet, amigo. Those two, they cover their tracks well. But my people are working on it. We will know something soon. In the meantime, my revolutionary brothers in Itaqua stand ready to help if you need them. Just call, and they will come.
I'll keep that in mind.
Two saxophone.
No worries.
Compadre, I may have someone who can give you information on Yuri and Polito.
I'm listening.
One of my lieutenants managed to escape from them. He fled to a village called Culta. Rather than give my men up to the cartel, the villagers hid him.
Goddamn bravery right there.
In response, Santa Blanca razed every home and executed all the villagers.
Fuck.
My lieutenant is still being kept alive. Probably so he can be killed in an even more painful way.
Understood. We're heading to Culta now.
Thank you.
guarde su arma. Ya.
Estamos con ustedes.
you, love. Su arma. Guarde su arma. ¿Ya? Ay, no. No tenga piedad.